championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Should the Lakers trade for Collin Sexton? I know the knee-jerk reaction that you're probably all shouting at your screens right now is yes, trade for this guy, do it. But it's a lot more complicated than that. What I want to do is break down exactly from the Lakers' perspective what a trade would look like and why it could get very, very complicated very quickly, to the point where maybe you question whether or not you do it. I'm going to dive into it, but first make sure you do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, and don't forget to ring that notification bell as well. All right, so a piece over on The Athletic suggested that Collin Sexton is very available, that the Cavs would like to move on from him. They have to pay him next year. He has 1 year left on his rookie deal, and it seems fairly likely that they're going to grab a guard in the NBA draft, somebody they're going to want to give minutes to, and clearing out Collin Sexton would allow them to do that. This is a very talented player. Look, we all saw him last season essentially beat the Brooklyn Nets single-handedly. I mean, incredible display. Has shot the three ball pretty well. Pretty dynamic on the offensive end of the floor. Defense needs some work, but I think the big question for the Lakers, before we even get into should they trade for him or not, it's is he that guy? That's what the Lakers have to decide. That is the first step here. Is he that guy? And by that, I mean, is he the guy that you want alongside Anthony Davis long-term? Because if you trade for him, he's at the end of his rookie contract next offseason. You're going to have to pay him to keep him. So you have to be certain, or at least relatively sure, that he is that guy moving forward. He's the piece that can be a second star alongside Anthony Davis after LeBron James rides off into the sunset, which is probably going to happen at some point. But again, the question is, can Collin Sexton be that guy? The second star alongside Anthony Davis in the future, and for the time being, a third star level player next to LeBron and AD. I personally think the answer is yes. I think he can be those things. But I think there's an argument here. This isn't a smash accept yes answer. There's certainly a little bit of doubt in my mind. And that's why the Lakers, the first step they have to answer is he that guy? Because if the answer is no, if the Lakers dive into everything and they say no, or we think it's at least doubtful, then you probably don't do what I'm going to outline here. So according to a recent piece by The Athletic, not only is he available, but they suggested that maybe the Cavs might want to attach Collin Sexton to Kevin Love in order to move Kevin Love's salary off the books. This is very similar to what the Lakers did a few years ago when they used D'Angelo Russell in order to move Timofey Mozgov off of their books. If you think back to what the Lakers got at the time, it's essentially Brook Lopez and a first round pick. However, we can't say, okay, the Lakers just need to give up the equivalent of Brook Lopez and a first in order to get Collin Sexton and Kevin Love, because you know it was years ago, values change, things change, all of that. But it's a very similar idea to what the Lakers did a few years ago. Nobody wants Kevin Love. At this salary, he'll be turning 33 years old. He hasn't had a fully healthy season in about 5 years now. He only scored 12 points per game last season, did not look happy in Cleveland, and he's making $31.3 million this year and then $28.9 million next year. Yeah, it declines a little bit next year, so at least there's that, I guess. He can be a floor spacing big. I think Kevin Love, though, is an example of the effect we see where we're so obsessed with a player's contract and how bad a contract might be that we conflate that with the player's value himself on the floor. Can Kevin Love still do things on the NBA court to help you win basketball games? Yes, I believe that. He can be a floor spacing big for you. Again, getting up there in years, but you could put him on the floor. Look, if Kevin Love was $5 million, I think a lot of teams in the NBA would take that gamble. However, he's not. He's $31 million, and that's why teams see him as such a negative value, and that's why you have to attach a positive asset like Collin Sexton in order to move him. For the Lakers, if you're going to do something like this, you're going to take the gamble that the Blake Griffin effect is real, and by that, I mean Kevin Love looked bad on a bad team, but when he comes to a good team like the Lakers, he will look much more useful. That's the hope for the Lakers, and anyone really in trading for Kevin Love. That part of it is he's a veteran player. He's on a bad team. He's not giving it all on a bad team right now, but on a good team where his role is a little bit diminished, where he can focus in on doing just a few key things out on the floor, he can be much more impactful. We saw Blake Griffin do that after leaving the Detroit Pistons for the Brooklyn Nets this last season. So that would be the hope if you trade for Kevin Love, that maybe you can get $10 to $15 million worth of value out of him. No, he will not be worth that $31 million, and you know that. But again, the next season, $29 million essentially expiring contract. Not to say they can move him, but maybe it's something to consider. But then the real prize, you'd be getting Collin Sexton, solid three-point shooter, pretty dynamic offensive player. The defense needs some work. He's young, could be a future star. So that is the upside to doing something like this. How do the Lakers get there math-wise? And that's where this gets really tricky, because Kevin Love is making so much. You're talking about roughly $39 million in salary coming out from the Cleveland Cavaliers. So right off the bat, Kyle Kuzma, $13 million. KCP, $13 million and change. Both of those have to be in the deal. So you're parting with both of those pieces, one of your key reserves and one of your starters, gone. On top of that, you need another $10 million or so, and you could get that with Montrezl Harrell. He has a player option for next season that pays him just over $9 million. If he were to opt in, then you could add him to the deal, and you're good. You've gotten there math-wise. You can make it work. However, that's where things get complicated. Montrezl Harrell does not have to tell the Lakers whether or not he's opting into his contract until the end of July. Why is that a complication? Because the Lakers don't make their draft pick until the draft on July 29th. Yeah, before Montrezl Harrell has to decide whether or not he's opting in. So the Lakers won't know whether or not they've got that salary to use. And you'd have to imagine that the Cavs in any deal would probably ask for the 22nd pick in the NBA draft to be part of it. And if that's the case, the Lakers would be selecting for the Cleveland Cavaliers at the 22 pick. And if they don't have Trez's salary to use, they can't make that deal unless they have something else set up in place. And something else would have to mean a sign and trade of one of three guys, either Alex Caruso, Talen Horton-Tucker, or Dennis Schroeder, heading out to the Cleveland Cavaliers as part of this deal. And the challenge there, just like it is with Montrezl Harrell, is do any of them actually want to go to the Cleveland Cavaliers? Because if the answer is no, then they simply won't sign the contract that would send them to Cleveland. You can also argue, would the Lakers really do that deal if you have to include a Talen Horton-Tucker to get it done? If you have to include Alex Caruso to get it done. Dennis Schroeder probably doesn't want to go to the Cleveland Cavaliers based on the comments that he's said in the past in terms of wanting to be a key player on a contending team. That certainly doesn't seem to be what the Cleveland Cavaliers are right now. So that brings us back to Montrezl Harrell and that player option. If he doesn't want to go to Cleveland, he simply opts out and signs somewhere else. Now, it's possible the Lakers and the Cavs, if the Cavs really believe in him and they say, look, Trez, we want you to be our first big off the bench behind Jared Allen. You're going to be our go-to guy out there on the floor. We're going to get you plenty of minutes. Maybe that is something that he wants to do. He wants to opt into his deal. He would be a free agent the following offseason and feels like he could kind of show his stuff in Cleveland. That is certainly possible. Or if the Cavs want to really prove their long-term commitment to him, they could do a sign and trade with him where the Lakers would have him opt out, sign him to a deal starting at around $11 million, and then use that as part of the trade to the Cleveland Cavaliers. The Lakers can offer Trez about $11 million after he opts out of his contract, if that's indeed the route that he chooses. Again, maybe he decides to opt in and then become a free agent next offseason. Like I said, this gets complicated pretty quickly. So ultimately, in order to make this deal work, Kyle Kuzma, KCP, they're in it. Trez, very much a wild card in how that works. If Trez just says, I don't want to go to Cleveland, that puts a major hurdle for the Lakers to try to clear in order to get this done, if indeed Kevin Love has to be part of a Collin Sexton trade. Now, there is one other complicating factor here, and that is Dennis Schroeder. You have to know, if you're the Lakers, where you stand with Schroeder before you move forward on something like this. If Schroeder says, I'm out, somebody else is going to offer me a big contract, I'm going to go sign there, and I'm just walking into their cap space, okay, you go ahead and you push forward and try to make a move with Collin Sexton. Or maybe you've already got a sign and trade setup. Wouldn't that be great? If you're going to lose Dennis Schroeder and you have an opportunity to bring in Collin Sexton, the ideal scenario for the Lakers would be to sign and trade Schroeder so you could actually get something back. Heck, maybe you could include him in the Cavs deal for Sexton. But again, I don't see Schroeder wanting to go to Cleveland based on the things that he's talked about being important to him in the past. But maybe you do work out another sign and trade with another franchise and you're able to get something for him in return. However, if you don't know, or if you have any kind of an inkling that you might want to bring Dennis Schroeder back, it would make this trade a bit more challenging, because bringing in Collin Sexton would almost certainly end your relationship with Dennis Schroeder. He wouldn't want to come back to the Lakers if they just brought in a player to replace him in Collin Sexton. So as I said, this gets complicated very, very quickly. But Again, you go back to the initial question. If you are the Lakers, when you're looking at should we trade for Collin Sexton, you have to decide, is he that guy? If you believe he is that guy that is going to be a star in the future, then you do what it takes in order to get him. And that might mean dealing with the awkwardness of the Dennis Schroeder situation. That might mean trying to negotiate something with Montrezl Harrell. Remember, Trez is a Clutch Sports client. The Lakers do have a good relationship with them there. Maybe there's something that they could work out that would get Trez to Cleveland and get him the money that he wants, or at least get him the opportunity that he wants. It's a tough road. It is not a simple trade for the Lakers to execute, but this is the path they will have to go down if they want to get in on the bidding for a promising young player in Collin Sexton. Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Is all of this worth it in order to get Collin Sexton? All the hoops the Lakers would have to jump through. It's not an easy task to get there if Kevin Love has to be part of the trade. So let me know your thoughts. And don't forget, guys, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. The offseason is quickly approaching, and that means things are going to heat up regarding trade and free agent rumors. So make sure you do subscribe, and don't forget to turn on those notifications as well. Till next time, stay safe. And see ya.